Hi children, welcome back to environmental studies class. So today we are going to start with our chapter number 7, that is experiments with water. In chapter number 6, we studied that where do we get this whole water from and how we use it, where we use it and what are the methods to conserve it and keep it safe for future use and everything, because it is something which we get from the nature and it is being used up very fast and is made on a very low basis in the nature. So in this chapter we are going to learn about what experiments we can perform along with water and how magical it is. So along with air, water is essential for the existence of mankind. Yes, we all know that air is needed for breathing, water is needed to survive. It is a basic necessity of a human being's life. Water exists above the earth's surface in many forms. It exists in form of liquid, in solid, in gases, how I'll tell you. And also below the earth in the form of underground water, it is there. Now, water survives in all three states of matter. What are the three states of matter? First is solid, second is liquid, third is gas. How? Solids means, as you can see in the picture, ice cube is solid. The small particles in green you see in the box are the molecules. Everything is made up of molecules. So the solid molecules are closely packed. They does not have any kind of space between them. So we can call this a solid Texotape. We can call this bottle a solid. Okay, so these are solid. They have definite shape, definite volume, and they cannot be like given any other shape. They are they have fixed shape every single time. So these things are known as solid. This pen is also a solid. What about liquids? Liquid means the molecules are loosely packed. They can take the shape of the container they are put into. This is another second matter of state. So water, any kind of water, liquidy state, juice and everything exist in the form of liquid. Water can exist in all three forms, but here I am taking a basic example. So this is liquid. Its molecules are loosely packed, so they don't have definite shape, but yes, they have definite volume. They can float very easily. They do not stay at one place because of their running capacity, because of their running property. The third state of matter is gas. It is visible sometimes, it is not visible. Gases have particles, its molecules are very far away from each other. So they don't have definite volume, they don't have definite shape at all, but they can be pressurized and put into containers. They take the shape of the things which they are put into again. So these are the three states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. And water being an universal thing and a very magical thing, it exists in all three forms, that is solid state also in form of ice, then a normal water what you drink in liquid state, and then it can be evaporated and turns into vapor, that is gaseous state. So so water exists in all three states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. Now some things float on the water and some things sink on the water. You all know this. You all are aware about it. Many a times we put, the small children put a lot of things inside the water just to have a fun of it. Some things float, something will not float. Let us see what floats and what not and why. Aisha was waiting for dinner today. Ammi was making her favorite food, puri and spicy potatoes. So puri aloo. Her mom was making puri aloo for her. Aisha watched as her mother rolled out a puri and put it in a hot oil. She was rolling the puri on a rolling pin and she put that into the hot oil. She saw that the first puri sank to the bottom of the pan. As it puffed up, the puri came up and started floating on the oil. So now, when initially it was plain roti, the puri was plain, it went into the pan and it went down at the bottom of the pan. Why? Because it was not a little heavier, but after it got puffed up, the air flow filled into it, it got lighter and it came up. On seeing this, Aisha took some dough herself, rolled it into a ball, she flattened it and put it into a bowl of water, but it sank. Well, we'll discuss this. In the evening, Aisha went for bath. She had just come out when her mother called, "Aisha, you have dropped the soap in the water again. Take it out and put it into the soap case." So what she did, she went into the washroom. She took out that soap from the water, which was at the bottom of the bucket. Now, it's Tarna, but in a hurry, she dropped the soap case into the water also. Instead of taking out the soap first, she dropped the soap case in which she was about to put the soap also in the water. But it was floating. It was not sinking. The soap was sinked, went into the bucket, but the soap case in which we keep soap was floating on the water. Have you seen that something float on the water while others sing? Have you seen that? You have seen it many times, but you may be wondering what it is. Let me explain you. Everything displays water equals to its volume. Okay? Whatever the volume of the thing is, everything displaces water. For example, if you take a glass of water and you put a little something into it, it is going to displace a little water. It is going to take a place inside it in of water. If the displaced water is more than the weight of a particular thing, then the object floats. On the other hand, when the displaced water is less than the weight of an object, it sinks. Now, let's see this. This is a nice stone I have here. If I am going to put it into a water like this, okay? Now what I am going to do, I am going to take this jar here. It is full of water. And I'm just going to simply put this stone into the jar. Now you will see, as soon as I put it, it goes into the bottom of the jar. It is sinked. Why? Well, this particular stone has taken some place inside the jar. It has displaced a little water. Okay? Displacing means it has taken a place of some water. Now what happens when the water which has been displaced is less than the weight of this stone, the stone sank. On the other hand, if I am going to put this so when I take this screw in my hand here, it also sinks. Why? Because it is displacing the water less than its weight. Now I'm taking this cap here. It is a cap of a tube. I'm taking this and I will put it. It is floating. Can you see, guys? It is floating on the water. Why? Because it displaced the water more than its weight. It has displaced water more than its weight, so it is floating. Now this cap, once again, another cap. So here, again, it is floating. Okay? So, here is the line written, everything displays water equals to its volume. What is volume? Your existence, the space you take is your volume. Okay? The space this bottle is taking, it's its volume. The space this little fancy stick is taking, it's its volume. The space taken by unoccupied by a substance is known as its volume. So everything displays water according to its volume. So when the displaced water is less than the weight, the object sinks, and when the displaced water is more than the object volume of the object floats. Am I clear on to this? Now let's move to a very interesting thing, that is Dead Sea. Dead Sea is a sea full of salt. Why it is known as Dead Sea? Because it has so much salt content in it that not a single aquatic life, that means no fishes, no sharks, not a single aquatic animal survives into it. So all oceans and seas have salty water, but the saltiest of all is the Dead Sea. How salty? Imagine taking a 300 gram of salt in 1 liter of water. Would we even to taste? Means 1 liter of water, that is approximately equal to 750 grams, and in that, out of that 750 grams, it is 300 gram of salt. Imagine how salty it would be. So would you be able to even taste such salty water? No, it would be very bitter. Interestingly, even if a person does not know how to swim, he she would not drown in sea they will float on the water. Why? Dead Sea has a great amount of salt in it, and a high salt content makes the water very dense. Therefore, the person will float in Dead Sea as his weight is less than displaced water. Of course, the density of the water is more because there is already a salt is there in the water, so much salt that the little water which is on which the surface on which the person is lying, he is going to displace very less amount of water. That's why that person is going to float on this. Thank you so much. This was the end of part one. I'll see you in part two with some more experiments. We are going to learn about solubility and insolubility of some substances into the water. In this part, I hope you understand everything. See you next time.